What's up, guys? Chris from Closet Weave here, and we're back on my Closet to Watch Season 2, Episode 16 of Urusei Yatsura. So last episode, we completed that date between Asuka and Shitaro. It wasn't just a regular date, obviously. Unfortunately, Asuka wasn't able to get over her fear of men. Everything was just back at square one. They were doing their best. Ataru interrupting, using Shitaro as a puppet when he was passed out. In the end, Asuka's mom tried her best to try and help Asuka, but just didn't work out. And Asuka and Tone sleeping in the same bed at the end of the episode. But hey, wouldn't have it any other way. All the characters acting exactly the same as they started. Now let's see what we got next. And I need to get better at doing this. I do have a Patreon, so if you guys want to check out unedited, uncut reactions, and they'll be released earlier on there, go ahead and check that out. I'll put a link in the description below. And for the Urusei Yatsura fans, I'm planning to watch the original and then post those only on the Patreon, maybe after this season is finished. If you guys want to check those out, you can be on the lookout for that. So let's jump into Season 2, Episode 16 of Urusei Yatsura. Nagisa's fiancé, the fairy's parasol. What the? We're on a cruise? Oh, Lum outside exploring. Okay, look at the outfit. Oh. Yeah, how are you gonna get more customers? Yeah, but that'd be pretty cool to just buy an island like that. ¥300? Yeah, I was gonna say, isn't that cheap? Uh-oh, where's Ataru? Oh! Hold up! We got another spirit? Is this about to be another sad story? They were listening the whole time. Oh, is that why they stole it for cheap? Because it's haunted. Whoa. Aww. Dang. What's going on this island? People just dying? A spirit. Shaved ice? Aww. They're still working. Still working in the afterlife. Why do they look like Frankenstein? Aww. Break the ice? Shaving some ice? Aw, that was his best friend. He thinks she's a boy too? Oh no. Oh, he said no matter the circumstances. Oh, she's hurt. Now it's Ryunosuke's turn. We had Otaru, the first spirit, going on a date with that girl. If they're on this island, I'm assuming... Oh, never mind, an urchin? Was it poisonous? I was gonna say it might have been like a typhoon or something, tsunami. Yeah. Urchin shaved ice. So he just ate too much? He has a 98? '166, '98, and '166. They just overate. And still calling Ryunosuke a boy. Come on, Pops. Hey, can you do that, Ryunosuke? One kiss? Hey, one kiss. I think you can make it happen, Ryunosuke. No one ever wants to hear her out. Just let her say it. Just let them explain. Oh. Okay, so they're all on board, just letting Ryunosuke give one kiss. Oh, see, the dad doesn't care. Yeah, the dad's like, just help her pass. The peer pressure. Ta 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 ta. Get out of here, Pops. I was just thinking about doing it. Dang, so romantic. On the beach. And she wakes up. Oh. You're a ghost! Let me check! Oh, of course, what's the legend? Oh gosh! A giant urchin? Shoot! Okay... Very convenient. Just gotta touch the tears and you become solid. Oh, the magic. The legend. Hey, you got your chance. Come on, Ryunosuke. You gotta do it. Help her pass on. Before Otaru gets to her. Something feels off. Oh, they're not. Dang, they got a little bit of respect over here. Oh, of course she's strong too. Oh. the wall move. How wonderful. Look at that, she doesn't care either. Oh, she's a boy? Alright. Okay, your guys' dads are built a little different. There should be no problem now, Ryunosuke. Oh, too late. Is that why Ataru and Chutaro didn't go after? Because they had that sense? Oh, he's just part of the world now? Oh Lord, now you're taking on the role, Pops. Is that 10 gen? Ooh. Picking on the little man. Look at him spending time with 10. Get burned. He's ready. Hey, sometimes those kids need a little Oh, got him dreaming. You thought. You'll never get a victory over Ataru. Whoa. Is it still a dream? Okay, got a nice little fairy here. What's your dream? I wonder what Ten's dream is gonna be. Oh, that looks like the biggest dream. Stupid turd. Oh, his mind is made. Oh, we fighting. Come on, Ten. Burn him. Oh. Oh, he got it. Oh, Lum. Oh, like you said, he can't fly fast. Where's that water coming from? Dewdrops. Then the mama bird. Oh, yup. Oh shoot. Uh oh. Yeah, that's gonna make Ataru angry. Oh no. And then Ataru's gonna come in and add. He's gonna add to it. Oh, there he is. Snatched it. Oh, Lum, looking after 10. Quick burn. Oh, nice little rainbow. Alright, what are you dreaming for? Ataru's house? Oh! That's it? Wait, I was like locked in. Alright, so we started off with Ryunosuke and her dad buying an island, taking it from an old friend. And unfortunately, they passed away after eating shaved ice with urchin, and I think it's the eggs of the urchin. And then Ryunosuke's dad and his friend made a promise that their kids would marry each other no matter what the circumstances are. And the big surprise was that Nagisa, who looked like a girl, is actually a boy. And Ryunosuke looks like a boy, is actually a girl. And in order for Nagisa to pass on to the afterlife, they needed a kiss. But then that whole legend with the big urchin came to the island, and Nagisa was able to have a physical body now. So it looks like we got a new character with Nagisa. And I think his dad can still visit at nighttime or something. So yeah, new character, another miscommunication going on with the genders there. And then we just had Ten helping out that fairy get his parasol, and that fairy can grant any dream. And for Ten, the dream that that came true was the dream he had at night with Ataru crushing him and his dragon with that big foot. But yeah, that episode felt like it flew by. I was still locked in, ready for more. But hey, another fun episode of Urusei Yatsura. Can't wait to see what happens next. If you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next one.